I come from about an hour from here when I'm saying I'm coming from home. I really come from a planet that's 4.3 to 4.5 light years away from here, traveling at a speed of 48 to 52 light years in one Earth color. I am a hybrid. I've been now aboard a ship 80 times in my lifetime before I was 62 years old. The largest spaceship I was on north of the city of Chicago. At that time, Chicago was 40 miles from the north to the south, 20 miles from the east to the west. It only had 13 decks, but the bottom deck was half a mile high. So, given to consider the size of Chicago, you know how big some of the ships are. I have been aboard many ships that were known as a three-man pod, which means they would have the captain and a two-person crew. If they took me aboard, it was a captain, myself, and some other navigator. So we, that's some of the basic facts on the thing. I will answer questions as they come up. If anybody has got questions, please raise a hand or some other signal that I can watch and try to answer the questions as intelligently as I possibly can. I'm going to start out from my first experience with a UFO.
I'm sorry, Don, could you turn it up just a little bit so we could all hear? Thank you.
Is that any better?
Thank you, Don.
Thank you very much for bringing that up. I appreciate that. I want all of you to listen to what I've got to say. My first experience that I remember of a UFO was when I was approximately 2 years old. I lived at Waterloo, Wisconsin. A tornado came through the area and uprooted trees that were 3.5 to 4 feet in diameter at ground level. The tornado went directly over our house, and the only damage done to our house was 1 foot of rain guard taken off from the roof. So that's pretty remarkable in my general standpoint. The tornado, or my people told me that I would definitely be safe. I went in the basement and listened to my parents at that time. Now that's a pretty early start in life to have a UFO experience and be able to remember. Unfortunately, my people do a very good job of administering temporary amnesia to people that have been abducted. Now, the only thing about this is if the right person says the right word or the right phrase, you will be becoming aware of your experiences on UFOs. The experience that you have had will come to your mind pretty gradually. It won't hit you right between the eyes with the 3x4 and the spike right here. So you're going to wind up remembering your experiences a little out of time after the right person gives you the right word and phrase. Now, in a UFO situation, if you were to think of the military on this planet, I maintain a rank of a general, because I've been aboard a ship so many times. But my purpose is to educate anybody that wants education on UFOs. I am not to charge a penny for any information exchange. All the information I give you is to be free. Now, I've joined the UFO in a reincarnated state. Reincarnation is when you come back to the planet, not in a different life form, but something like this. You go through one life, and you go into another period of rest, and then you come back into another life form. Well, I signed it back in my rest period, and I would go aboard a ship 70 times. Now, unfortunately or fortunately, the situation is they needed my help for other members of UFO clans, so they extended my tour many times. My tour ended when I was 61 years old. I'm 73 now, that's 12 years ago. So I've had many experiences that many of you would only dream about. I've been on different planets. One planet that I was on, the soil was a chocolate kind of brown. They took me and my family group of people that went aboard the same spaceship for different experiments or things like this. And they take the whole group at one time. And then when it comes around again, we go again as a family group. That's not a family like here on Earth, where you have your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, or whatever. It's a family group. You have your bodyguards, you have your people that advise you of what you're about to see. You have many different facets. I have three of my four bodyguards. I have a wife that we were married on out in outer space. The planet Earth looked about the size of halfway between a good sized grapefruit, a large orange, or something like that. That's a whole ways out. Now, I've had three implants in my life. Three implants in my life. I had one up here, way up in the brain, above the eyes. They went through the nostrils to put it in. I had an implant in between my shoulder blades, just about an inch lower than I can reach. And I had an implant in the lumbar region of my back. The my people tell me that they knew where I was. In a 10-meter circle, and a football.